Hi everyone, I'm Phil Nash from DataStax, and this is how to scrape just the web content you need with Readability.js. Now, if you've ever done anything with large language models, LLMs, and particularly Retrieval-Augmented generation, RAG, then you'll know that LLMs work really well with unstructured data. However, that data is just lying all over the place, from PDFs and CSVs to web pages and intranets, or even the open web. Now, in this video, I want to look at web pages because getting the data out of them isn't as straightforward as you might think. For example, this is the simplest code that you can use to pull data from a web page. We use fetch to make a request to a URL, in this case of a blog post that I wrote, and then we parse that into text. We can look at that outcome, look at that HTML, and see that, well, we've got all the HTML, but it's quite a mess. Like, there's a lot of stuff there, a lot of stuff that might well, you know, trip up an LLM. It might make our vector embeddings less useful. Ideally, we just want the content, the text of the article. Now, we could use a library like Cheerio, which gives us a jQuery-like syntax to traverse the document and pull out the parts that we want. I have Cheerio installed here, so I'm just going to import it to the page. And then we can make our like jQuery-like object by loading the HTML with the Cheerio library. And then we can kind of log out bits of the page. So let's take a stab at the main element, for example. And if we do that, then we get a much better example. We get just the text from the main element. And like, it has a bunch of interesting things here. Like it actually starts with a bunch of structured data before getting into the article. And at the end, it's got a bunch of sort of related blog posts and other links and things like that, which is not stuff we necessarily want. Now, we can be a bit more targeted, a bit more precise, and just pick out the bits of the page that we want. Like, let's look at the H1, and then because I happen to know the structure of this page, we can look at blog content, and then the actual first div within that. And if we look at that, you can now see we just have, this is just the text of the article, and at the top, we just get the title. None of that kind of cruft around it. The problem here is, this requires us to know the structure of all the pages we want to scrape. And so this is where Readability.js comes in. It's actually the library that powers reader mode in Firefox, extracted as a standalone library. If you don't know what reader mode in Firefox is, this is Firefox loaded up with that blog post that we've been looking at. And reader mode is just this little icon in the top. And if you hit that, it strips away all of the web page and just leaves you with a text-only view on the article. And so that's really useful. It doesn't have all the related links at the bottom. It just has this article. And that's kind of what we want with our, when we're kind of scraping this stuff. So in Node.js, we can use it. We can import readability from Mozilla Readability. We can also, what we also need to do is import JS DOM. And that's because, normally, this works inside the browser where there is a document available. But if we're going to do this in Node.js, we don't have a document to work with. We just have this kind of string of HTML. And so what we'll do is create ourselves a doc using JS DOM and the HTML. And we'll also pass in the URL to make sure links and relative links work. And once we've done that, we can create ourselves a reader, which is a new readability. Using the document, the window, and the document there. And once we've done that, we can now console.log reader.parse. And if we then look at the content we get out of that, we actually find ourselves with an object of data. And so this object comes with a title, it comes with the author, it comes with the content, and this is the HTML content. Then if we scroll down, we find out we've got a text content, there it is in the middle, and that's all the content from the article, and then finally we've got some other bits like the publish time, the site name, but with that we can do a couple of things, right? We can take that text content and split it into chunks, turn it into vector embeddings, and store it in a vector database like AstroDB. The HTML content we can actually use to do further processing on the data, like extracting images or tables and handling them differently. So there's a quick tip for you today. Readability.js is maintained by Mozilla, and it's battle-tested as a component of Firefox. It compiles out the data from web pages to make scraping them much easier as part of your ingestion pipeline for your RAG application.